Students and honored guests, please rise. Welcome to Columbia Southern University's 2013 commencement ceremony. Welcome, CSU graduates, family, and friends. Welcome, honored guests, faculty, and staff. I hereby declare this 2013 ceremony, commencement ceremony, to be open. You may be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Honorable Mayor Tony Kennan, Mayor of the City of Orange Beach.
Howdy. You're not in Texas, you're in Orange Beach, Alabama. We love you, we are so happy that you're here and appreciate you more than you will ever know. I'm just honored, and it's such a privilege for me to be here just to welcoming you and to be a part of this ceremony, because I have such respect and appreciation for Columbia Southern University and the Mays family. And I've known these guys for a long time, and I would buy a used car from any of them. And what I mean by that is I'm old school. They're a handshake bunch of folks. They give you their word, and you don't have to worry about it. They're going to do what they say they're going to do, and I appreciate them. They're a huge part of our community, so that makes you a huge part of our community. I feel the need to, let me ask you first, how many folks here are not from Alabama? How many of you knew that we had beautiful beaches, wear shoes, and pave our roads? Hey, we do, I promise. But, you know, I get behind a grew up Baptist, so I get behind a podium and a microphone, I feel the need to preach. And so I'm going to give you a 30-second mini testimonial. I went back to school at 25, 26, like a lot of you did. Truly respect you, because it's a lot tougher to go back. When I went back, I had to pay my own way. It only took me a quarter and a half to flunk out at 18. So, you know, at 31, I graduated, and I got a whole new set of tools and gifts that God helped me with, and now I'm out to change the world. Unfortunately, I changed the world, or made my path in a way of the world, money, fame, fortune, whatever. No peace, no contentment. At 42, the good Lord humbled me with a sledgehammer in the biggest way. He changed my heart. And what I'm saying to you is search your heart and find God's desire and will for your life, and you will find peace and contentment. But please, you do now have a whole new set of skills and tools. Take them and make a difference in the world. We're depending on you. My cell phone number, 251-747-8282. 251-747-8282. My number's in the book. If there's anything we can do in Orange Beach to make this a better place for you, anything you see we need to fix, I want you to call me. I mean that with all my heart. So even if it's nothing more than want to know where you should go eat or where you shouldn't go eat, so don't eat in Gulf Shores. Okay? So, but anyway, thank y'all. And again, I appreciate you more than you know.
Thank you, Mayor Kennan. I now have the honor of introducing our next speaker, Mr. Bradley Byrne. Bradley Byrne was born and raised in Mobile, Alabama, just a few miles from the site where his great-great-great-grandfather settled in the 1780s. After completing his undergraduate studies at Duke University, Bradley came home and received his law degree from the University of Alabama. In 1994, Bradley was elected to the Alabama State Board of Education. In 2002, Bradley won the Republican nomination and general election to the State Senate representing District 32. In 2007, Bradley was appointed as Chancellor at the Alabama Department of Postsecondary Education. Since 2010, Bradley has worked as an attorney in Mobile, focusing on economic developing efforts for a wide range of business clients. He has been married to his wife, Rebecca, for 32 years, and they share four wonderful children. Bradley lives in Fairhope, where he and his family are members of the St. James Episcopal Church. Please help me welcome Mr. Bradley Byrne.
Thank you so much, and welcome to everybody here today. I was the speaker at, I think, the first graduation here, and I can tell you it was a much smaller room back then, and to look at this great sea of faces, the graduates and the family, it tells me at how far this great institution has come, and it's come because it's an institution of high quality, and you've been attracted by that quality, and that's good for you and good for all of us that live in this great area. You know, each one of you have worked very hard to lift up yourself. And in lifting up yourself, you have lifted up your family. And you have lifted up your community. And collectively, you lift up our nation. Because every time one of us reaches a little bit higher, we're not just reaching for ourselves. We're reaching for those to whom we're connected. You've got a lot of wonderful family members out there today who are so very proud of you. And you've lifted them up by lifting yourself up. And the communities from which you come, obviously many of you not from this area, you're lifting up your communities by what you do for yourself and how you will reach out and lift up other members of your community. And this great nation is made better every day because individuals like you have taken the time and put in the effort to make you who you are. So thank you. Thank you from the people that live in this area, and thank you from the people that live in our great country for what you have done for yourself and what you have done for all of us. God bless you, and may you have a great future.
Thank you, Mr. Byrne. Wow, graduates, you look amazing. I am so proud of you. This is your day. Even though this may be a chapter that you finished, there's so much more in that book that you've got to conquer and move forward in your life. We've seen you set your goals, and we've been a part of your life to set your educational goals, and to watch you have achieved them is incredible to all of us. I personally know many of you have those stories of triumph where you faced all odds in order to be here today. Can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Okay. It's an honor to have with us today the Naval Air Technical Training Center Performing Unit and Mr. Tommy Cooley singing the national anthem. Please stand for the Parade of Colors and the National Anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
And now Reverend Buford Lipscomb from Liberty Church in Pensacola, Florida, will deliver the invocation.
Let us pray together this afternoon. Father, we lift up this special day for all of these. We pray, Lord, over the proceedings of this, the 2013 Columbia Southern University commencement exercises. Lord, we mark with the faculty and the staff this great achievement on their behalf, but more so, Lord, we celebrate and honor these many graduates and their families today. We thank you for their persistence. Lord, we thank you for their faithfulness and the great sacrifice that they have made to come to this important place in their lives today here in Orange Beach, Alabama. Now, Lord, we pray that you would come in the power of your love and presence and bring alive this ceremony in such a way that it'll be one that's long remembered and very significant in the future throughout the lives of all of these. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
You may be seated. Today I have the honor of introducing to you my brother, CSU President Robert Mays. Now there's a funny story here. In the first service, I had a graduate come and ask me, is he your brother in the Lord or is he blood? Well, he's both. So I just want to get that out in the open. Robert has been president since 2005, assuming this role after the unexpected death of our father. I can say with total confidence that he has done a supreme job of leading CSU these last 8 years. Robert is fully committed to CSU's mission and vision, which is to change and improve lives through higher education and to enable them to maximize their professional and personal potential and serve their communities in which they live and work. Robert and I have worked together for now over 20 years, and I am so proud of what he has accomplished, and I'm excited to see him continue to lead CSU into the future. Please join me in welcoming your president, President Robert Mays.
I'm blessed to have a great sister, by the way. Well, welcome everyone. What a wonderful, wonderful day. I want to thank you graduates for choosing Columbia Southern University as your institution. Since 2012, our ceremony last year, 6,609 graduates have completed their degree programs at CSU. And today, between both ceremonies, we are honored to have 550 graduates in attendance with 2,500 family and guests. If we were a traditional university where most all graduates attended a commencement ceremony and they brought the average number of family and friends and guests as you did, around 30,000 people would be in attendance today and we would need a much larger auditorium. So thank you for choosing to participate in this event with us. I'd like to also welcome our online viewers. We are streaming this ceremony live. CSU has a very strong active student body alumni, which you are now part of. There's over 30,000 students and nearly 29,000 alumni all across the country and the world. We strive to offer exceptional service and take good care of you, and I hope you know that very well. We're also proud to have over 2,500 organizations that are learning partners with Columbia Southern. So today we celebrate this hard work with you, and let's please everyone, let's give our graduates an applause. CSU has approximately 44% of our student body as active military or veterans. And we are very proud to be the sixth largest institution by enrollment serving the active military, according to DoD data published by Military Times. So whether you're a guest or graduate, if you're a veteran or active duty military member, please stand and let us applaud you. Thank you so much for what you do. We also are a very strong institution in the world of public safety and law enforcement, fire, and emergency services. So if you are in those fields, whether you're a guest or graduate, please stand and allow us to applaud you. Thank you. Now, graduates, you come from far and near. Many of you have traveled a great distance to be here throughout the country and throughout the world. So we're going to have a little bit of fun. We're going to call out each state you've traveled from, and I'll call them out in groups of seven and countries individually, and I ask that the audience hold their applause to the end, but as I call your state, stand and remain standing. And you and all the audience, please feel free to shout, to scream, or make some strange noise as I call your state and have a good time. All right, let's begin. Alaska, Alabama, Arkansas, Arizona, California, Colorado, Connecticut, and Florida. Thank you. You may be seated. Next group, Georgia, Hawaii, Iowa, you're a quiet group, Illinois, Indiana, Kansas, Kentucky, Louisiana. Give them a round of applause. Next group, Massachusetts, Maryland, all right, Maine, Michigan, Minnesota, Missouri, Mississippi, Montana. All right, thank you. Next group, North Carolina. You guys are always loud. It's great. North Dakota, Nebraska, New Jersey, New Mexico, Nevada, New York, Ohio. All right. Give a round of applause, please. Next group, Oklahoma, Pennsylvania, Rhode Island, South Carolina, Tennessee, Texas. I was born in Texas, by the way. Virginia, Washington. Give a round of applause. All right, our last group, it's a shorter group, Wisconsin, West Virginia, Wyoming. And is there any other state I missed? Nope. All right, give them a round of applause, please. Hang on a minute, I didn't catch it. You got to stand up. What state? Washington, D.C. Give her a round of applause, please. Okay, now we go to countries. Would all those from the country of Vietnam please stand? Oh, I'm sorry, guys, I'm on the wrong column. All right, all of our Vietnam graduates were in this morning's ceremony. Saudi Arabia, please stand. Let's give a round of applause anyway, if we would. Luxembourg. You here? Yes, there we go. Hope I pronounced that correctly. Are there any countries that I missed? Nope. All right. Thank you, guys. That was a great event. All right, so graduates, you have shown the world through your perseverance, dedication, that you can and will succeed, and we are so glad to have been a part of that. This hat is bothering me. My parents started Columbia Southern University back in 1993. My father, Dr. Mays, passed away in 2005. However, Mimi remains a great inspiration for this institution, and I would like her to stand and please receive these flowers, a token of our appreciation for her. Thank you. We also have some of our trustees here today. They do a wonderful job of governing Columbia Southern University. I'd like to recognize them and please remain standing when I call your name. Chief Forney Howard, Mrs. Mimi Mays, and Chantel Cooley. Give them a round of applause, please. Thank you. So sitting over to your left is pretty much all of our program directors, the leaders of your academic programs, and many of our faculty. They have the most significant interaction with you, our students, and more than anyone, they have contributed to laying the foundation for your CSU learning experience. After the ceremony, they'll hang around in that area, and I please encourage you to go over there and greet them and meet them if you would like. Let's give them a round of applause. Offering exceptional student service would not be possible again without our faculty and our program directors who are committed to going beyond the call of duty to help our students reach your goals. The Robert G. Mays Senior Distinguished Faculty of the Year Award was established to recognize and honor outstanding achievements and contributions by a CSU faculty member, and this is voted on by the student body. I am proud to announce the recipient of the 2013 Robert G. Mays Senior Distinguished Faculty of the Year Award is Dr. Daryl Gulliford. Dr. Gulliford, please come up. Dr. Gulliford was born and raised in Northwest Ohio, graduated from Ohio State University, and practiced respiratory therapy and cardiovascular perfusion prior to his training in healthcare administration at the University of Cincinnati. He received a master's degree in community health administration and health planning, and also studied in the British National Health Services, completing a fellowship in London. Daryl is now a fellow and diplomat of the American Academy of Medical Administrators and also a fellow of the American College of Cardiovascular Administrators. He has held CEO positions at 4 community hospitals since 91, including Community Memorial Hospital in Defiance, Ohio, which made the top 100 hospitals in America. He has constructed and opened new hospitals for the communities of Huggington, Kansas, and Holdenville, Oklahoma, also serving as district president and state vice president for the hospital associations of both Kansas and Oklahoma. Daryl helped to found the healthcare administration program for Columbia Southern in the early 1990s, working with Dr. Mays, my father. He loves teaching online and is very proud of the progress CSU has made, and we, of course, are very proud of him. Dr. Gulliver, it is my honor to present to you the Faculty of the Year Award. I give God all the credit for where this institution is at and how well it's done, and because, again, and thank you for choosing CSU. We are very, very blessed to have you here today. And you have my sincere congratulations. God bless.
I'm so excited to be here with you. I get to bring up our speaker, but I wanted to say a few things. It's in our heart to see you succeed, to know that our faculty and staff and all of us on the stage had a part to change your life is so awesome. We could just go home today and I'd be done with my rest of my life. I heard a story with a graduate in the previous graduation, but he actually was a firefighter and he was in a flashover and pretty much was an explosion. And he was in ICU and had a ventilator, and he was writing down to tell his wife and doctors he needs his books to finish his degree program. Now, isn't that determination? And I know many of you have told me stories. Yeah, let's give him a hand. I mean, that's pretty awesome. I know many of you have had the same stories where you had to conquer so many things to get here today. This is a lifelong dream, and now you're moving forward. It is now your time to shine. So I am so proud to be a part of that in your life. All right. Can't you tell I'm pumped up? I'm fired up for you. Okay. So let's get with it. I've got to get the speaker up here. We have a great speaker lined up for you. When you look for a speaker, you want someone to really inspire our graduates. And it's very important to us that you hear today will encourage you to continue to move yourself forward and go after your dreams. I can assure you this speaker will do just that. Today's commencement address will be offered by the president of Waldorf College, Dr. Bob Alsop. In April of 2011, the Waldorf College Board of Trustees selected Dr. Robert A. Alsop as the 16th president of Waldorf College. He joined Waldorf College in 1998 after receiving a doctorate in English from Southern Illinois University at Carbondale. During his tenure at Waldorf, he also served in a variety of roles, including Associate Professor of English, Chair of the English Department, Director of Honors College, Assistant Academic Dean of the College, and Interim Vice President for Academic Affairs. A native of Duluth, Minnesota, Dr. Alsop also earned a bachelor's degree in English from Concordia College in Moorhead, Minnesota in 1989, and a master's degree and doctorate in English from Southern Illinois University at Carbondale in 1993. He has an extensive record of scholarship in America and Renaissance literature, with papers that have been published or presented at regional, national, and international conferences. He has also received several awards for his teaching, including the Board of Trustees, Outstanding Faculty Award, and the Phi Theta Kappa Professor of the Year Award. He holds a membership in a number of professional associations, serves as a board member for several communities, organizations, and is a native member of Emmanuel Lutheran Church. He and his wife, Natalie, have two sons. Thank you, Dr. Alsop, for choosing to be a part of our graduates' special day. And if you'll join with me in welcoming Dr. Bob Alsop.
Well, I don't know if we have any Seinfeld fans here, but I'm reminded of George Costanza saying, if you take my whole life and reduce it down to about 15 seconds, sounds decent. So thank you for that, Chantel. Thank you for consulting with my mother as well. I appreciate that. And this hat isn't going to work for this. I'll tell you that right now. Before I get started, first I want Chantel and Robert and Mimi to stand up. You people need to understand that in my 25 years in higher education, I have never known people more passionate about higher education and what it can do to change your lives. So let's give them a round of applause. No, we're not going to do we're not at the country club. We're not going to do the golf course, polite applause. Give them what they deserve, people. There we go. You know, and I know we recognize the Board of Trustees. Students, you don't probably have too much of a knowledge of just what the board does here. But CSU has a wonderful board that's not just leading CSU, but leading higher education and in the type of impact that it can have now. So, Board Chair, if you would stand, and let's give him a real round of applause again for the work that they do. And how about the CSU faculty and staff? I know they've meant a lot to you. They've been on the phone with you, getting you enrolled in your next class, helping you when you have a paper due the next day and you're having trouble with the internet, right? That fact that they've been in the chat room, they've helped you with that paper when, oh man, how are you gonna get that done? Think of all those moments and give those people some love. And take a moment and look behind you. The people that came down with you here today, they're here with a real purpose. They've been through this with you. They've been alongside you. They've pushed you. They've probably encouraged you when you thought you just couldn't get it done. So let's give it up for those people. And graduates, stay seated. I'll get to you later. It is a true honor and privilege to be with you here today. I've been thinking as a student, a faculty member, administrator, I put on funny robes like this and the funny hat like that on more than 25 times for commencement activities. I've never spoken at a commencement before, but I think I've learned a couple of essential rules of doing this job. The first is, and you'll like this one, keep it short. The second one is, remember, this is a celebration. Okay? Any opportunity you have to shout out, give an amen, a woo-hoo, a hoo-ha, you go ahead and do it. Start now. This is your day. Robert and Chantel added a third to my list. I've been down here all week, and they're telling me that I need to inspire, too. And that, for me, frankly, is too tall of a task for this group, because no commencement speaker can inspire you the way the people in your life have inspired you to get to this day. I want you to take a moment right now to think of those people who have inspired you and are the most proud of you right now. It might be a parent, a child, a relative, a spouse, someone behind you in the crowd who's here with you today. It might be a CSU faculty or staff member who just would not let you quit, would not let you fail. It could be someone who's no longer with us in this life, but whose memory motivated you during those long nights of study. It could be a grade school teacher, a coach, a pastor, or a friend who has no idea about the real impact he or she has had on your life. So take a moment. Think of that person right now, sitting next to you right now, and what that person has meant to you. Now on the count of three, let's let out another cheer, an amen, a woohoo, whatever is inside you right now, and give it up for those people that have motivated you to this great achievement. One.
Oh, wait.
This was the final for your. One, two, three. Your charge, your duty now is to carry the inspiration of those people who inspired you, those people who are most proud of you right now. Because let me tell you, you are the inspiration, each and every one of you. I know that your stories inspire daily the faculty and staff at CSU. How many of you went and toured the facilities the last couple days at CSU? Great. Certainly you noticed. You noticed as you walked through the halls there, the frames that held quotes from students at CSU. The walls are literally covered with your stories. The quotes are not simply an expression of your gratitude for the education CSU provides, but a testament of all that you have had to do to make your educational dreams come true. It takes dedication. It takes real courage to do what you have done to get here today. How many of you served in the military while working on your degree. Let's hear it. How many of you pored over books and studied for exams while serving in law enforcement, fire, and in emergency services? How many of you worked full or part-time jobs while you're writing papers for your classes? How many of you studied either early in the morning before anyone in your house was awake, or stayed up after you put the kids to bed so as not to let your studying interfere with your family life? How many of you put off vacations, purchasing a car, or spending money on something a little special just so you could afford this degree today? And how many of you just simply had to tell a friend or a family member no, so you'd have time to study? You are here today because you sacrificed, you endured, you persevered. It was tough. In fact, if it hadn't been tough, you probably wouldn't be here today. We don't rejoice our success over the easy. We celebrate the triumph over the hard. It's the fact that it was difficult that makes today great. How many of you have seen the Tom Hanks movie, A League of Their Own? Seen that one? But the movie tells the story of the formation of a women's baseball league during World War II. While it was the dream of these women to play professional ball, it was tough. They endured humiliating jeers from the crowds, crummy travel accommodations, little care for their health, and in the case of the Rockford Peaches, an abusive coach. Remember, are you crying? There's no crying in baseball. Toward the end of the movie, the film's protagonist and star catcher of the Rockford Peaches, Dottie Hinson, quits the team. She tells manager Jimmy Dugan, "It just got too hard." Jimmy passionately responds, "It's supposed to be hard. If it wasn't hard, everyone would do it. The hard is what makes it great. And everything you have done, everything you have experienced to get here today has made you great." Yeah, well, that deserves something. To be sure, challenges will still come, but because of your CSU education, you are more ready than you have ever been before to handle those challenges. There may be times in the future when, like Dottie Hinson, you want to throw up your hands, run away, and give up. When that happens, think of this moment right now. Think of the feeling that you have right now. And know with confidence that you can do anything. Your education has been a great gift and something no one can take away from you. No one can take this away from you ever. But remember, to whom much has been given, much will be required. Your CSU degree will continue to serve you well, but more importantly, you are positioned to serve the world well. Your family, your community, your profession. This doesn't mean you stop learning and growing, but carry with you the knowledge that you are ready to have a great impact on the world. And that is my message for you today. Because the knowledge you have gained, the perseverance you have demonstrated, and the courage you have exhibited as a CSU graduate, you have it within you to face any challenge that comes your way. You have it within you to succeed in anything you encounter. You have it within you to change the world. To paraphrase Jimmy Dugan, the hard has made you great. And I mean that. I thank God for you, and I thank God for CSU, because the education CSU has provided and what you have learned, experienced, and created. Your future is not just brighter, but our future is brighter. Thank you, and let's continue to celebrate the day.
Thank you, Dr. Alsop. How about that for Dr. Alsop? Let's give it up for him. Inspirational message. Will the doctoral degree candidates please rise and come forward?
Dean Leader Jr.
President Mays, this candidate, Dean Leader Jr., has completed all the requirements for the doctorate degree. His dissertation is titled Alcohol Disease Management Programs and Productivity, a Retrospective Cohort Analysis. On behalf of the faculty, I recommend that the doctoral degree be conferred upon the candidate at this time.
With the authority granted to me by the state of Alabama and the approval of the board and faculty of Columbia Southern University, I hereby confer upon you the doctorate degree and all the rights and privileges that come with it. Please move your tassel from the right to the left side of your cap as a sign to all of this great achievement. I now present to you Dr. Dean Leader Jr.
Frank Inkum.
President Mays, this candidate, Frank Inkum, has completed all the requirements for the doctorate's degree. His dissertation is titled Expatriate Management, the Impact of Host Countries' National Contribution to Expatriate Success. On behalf of the faculty, I recommend that the doctoral degree be conferred upon the candidate at this time.
With the authority granted to me by the state of Alabama and the approval of the board and faculty of Columbia Southern University, I hereby confer upon you the doctorate degree and all the rights and privileges that come with it. Please move your tassel from the right to the left side of your cap as a sign to all of this great achievement. I now present to you Dr. Frank Inkum.
Kenneth Preston.
President Mays, this candidate, Kenneth Preston, has completed all the requirements for the doctoral degree. On behalf of the faculty, his dissertation was entitled Growth Ideas for Martial Arts. And on behalf of the faculty, I recommend that the doctoral degree be conferred upon the candidate at this time.
With the authority granted to me by the state of Alabama and the approval of the board and faculty of Columbia Southern University, I hereby confer upon you the doctorate degree and all the rights and privileges that come with it. Please move your tassel from the right to the left side of your cap as a sign to all of this great achievement. I now present to you Dr. Kenneth Preston.
Let's have another round of applause for the doctoral student. Will the master degree candidates please rise? Chairman Howard, these candidates have completed all the requirements for the master's degree. On behalf of the faculty, I recommend the master's degree be conferred upon them at this time.
With the authority granted to me by the state of Alabama and approval of the board and faculty of Columbia Southern University, I hereby confer upon you the master's degree and all the rights and privileges that come with it. Please move your tassel from the right side to the left side of your cap as a sign to all of this great achievement. I congratulate you and applaud you.
Will the candidates for the master's degree please come forward to receive your diploma?
Presenting the College of Business. Angela Rogers. Deborah Perry. Tanisha Davis. Christine Maxwell. Jill Palatucci. Samina McGee. Edwina Evans. Dawn Marie Clark. D'Angelo King. Sambraya L. Wright. Julia Bernard. Kimberly Jones. Roderick Sumter. Kirk Gamblin. Beverly D. Poole. Robert Lantman. Lamar Robert Norris. Elmar Lenz. Walia Bulwar. Lynette Smith. Gerald Garvey. Josette Joyner. James Corr. Mary Harris. Douglas Yurchik. Thomas Winslow. Anthony Robinson. Adriana Baldione. Nicole Michelle Paris. Morris Hicks. Lorenza King. Octavius Perkins. Kennarda Slaughter. Kareem Newsom Williams. Husseini Muhammad. Billy Devine. Betty Franklin. Tracy Newton. Kakeisha Smith. William Mosley. Adijoke Ijwafor. Latricia Dicker. Sudhir Shrestha. Betsy Berrios. Thomas William. Stanley Bannister. Brittany Davis. Damone Marianne Burton. Alvin Simonton Perry. Minu Hassani. Lanisa Ferguson. Gregory McQuitter. Samuel O. Story Jr. Derek Taylor. Marie Ferguson. Alfonso Ferguson Sr. Rodney Malaulu. Mona Walters. Lula Broom. Sherry Marks. Laquatia Emerson. Janet T. Watson. Elizabeth Jenga. Angela Hoyt. Caroline Adams. Elizabeth Webb Jones. Richard Thompson. Presenting the College of Safety and Emergency Services. Raphael Dunham. Ursula Gardner. Amy Mangia Capra. Roosevelt Smith. Hezekiah Harper. Randall Armstrong. John Rogers. Kenneth Kreese. Nathan Van Wick. Buluwaji Darrow. Melanie Street. Teresa Cummins. Edward Simmons. Kathy DeVault. Donna Newman. Nancy Bodenhammer. Jerry Eubank. Blake Watkins. Robin Miller. Kyle McClintock. Tony Lashley. Peter Morris. Karen Bob. William Levy. Miles Allen. Carlo Miller. James Franklin. Stephanie Taylor. Christopher Scamahorn. Charles Stevens. Tony Kone. Amber N. Stewart.
Let's have another round of applause for our master's degree students. Will the bachelor's candidates please rise? Chairman Howard, these candidates have completed all the requirements for the bachelor's degree. On behalf of the faculty, I recommend the bachelor degree be conferred upon these candidates at this time.
With the authority granted to me by the state of Alabama and approval of the board and faculty of Columbia Southern University, I hereby confer upon you the bachelor's degree and all the rights and privileges that come with it. Please move your tassels from the right to the left side of your cap as a sign to all of this great achievement. I congratulate you and applaud you.
Will each candidate for the bachelor's degree please come forward as your name is read to receive your diploma.
Presenting the College of Arts and Sciences. Ashley Bettis. Leah Williams. Lauren Hanrahan, cum laude. Elvia Ayala. Antonio Gibson. Jessica Trimble, cum laude. Presenting the College of Business, Tanya Elmore. Pamela McCullough, magna cum laude. Mary Jo Paget, summa cum laude. Elizabeth Pratt. Jason Heyer. Adam Wilson, summa cum laude. Xenia Boswell. Richard Galloway, magna cum laude. Melissa Lawrence. India Johnson. Nicole Renner, magna cum laude. Marjorie Trawick, magna cum laude. Danielle Earhart, magna cum laude. Anitra Nickerson. Tracy Hale. Pauline Muiruri, cum laude. Marcus Shaw. Paul Brent, cum laude. Ashley Dixon. Adonis Williams, cum laude. Ellen Preston, cum laude. Jamail Hawthorne Garrison. Joy R. Young. Michelle Davis. Lashika Coase. Tanika Pearson. Miriam Stewart. Yvonne Dubila Newell. Tiffany Walk. Jacqueline Jones. Doretha Godley. Gwendolyn Dunbar, cum laude. Juan Piper. Sabrina Gaddis. Jesse Little Page Rude. Deborah Bird Bowens. Jesse Horn. Ruth May Bain. April D. Dunning, summa cum laude. Anthony Skull. Corey Freeman. Marty Blaine, magna cum laude. Anita Currington. Randy Woodruff. Evan Pennington. Lynette Fletcher. Lloyd O'Quinn, magna cum laude. Jamie Hudgens. Stephen Palatucci, magna cum laude. Michelle Davis, magna cum laude. Shayla Elizabeth Lee.
Yeah, that's wifey.
Robert Colburn Lee. Jeremiah James. Sabrina West, cum laude. Enoje Oivia. Diamond Edwards. Stacy Thibodeau. Shirley Moore Schubert. Cassandra Barbie, magna cum laude. Tabitha Miller. Deborah Woodley, cum laude. Stacy Bryant, summa cum laude. Lana Porsche Mason, cum laude. Leslie Williams, cum laude. Blondie Williams. Demetria Wiley. Robert Walker, cum laude. Manfred Asu, summa cum laude. Paul Franklin. Don O'Neill, cum laude. Presenting the College of Safety and Emergency Services. Chris Thompson, magna cum laude. Sean Lucas, magna cum laude. Shawana Proctor. Jennifer Faulkner, magna cum laude. Jose Orellana. Amber Anzani. Christy Rhodes, cum laude. Ashley Johnson. Andrew Guth, magna cum laude. Marcus Bennett. Marcia Collins. Zahir Dean, magna cum laude. Shane Riley Page. Michael Mosley. Stacy Davis, magna cum laude. Kimberly Zarmack, magna cum laude. Elizabeth Nicole Duncan. Eddie Levins, magna cum laude. Kenneth Kerr. Ray Charles Hubbard, cum laude. Stephen Sutton, magna cum laude. Armour Savage. Melinda Brothers, magna cum laude. Douglas Schubert, magna cum laude. Michael Redican, summa cum laude. Kenise Mitchell. Leroy Mensack, cum laude. Donnie Gay. Lyndall Shrum, magna cum laude. Holly Hodnick, cum laude. Jeffrey Powers. George Daigle, summa cum laude. Ismael Sosa, summa cum laude. Vincent Harris, summa cum laude. Talisha Troop, cum laude. Tanya Zepeda. Scott Bowling. Stephen Waiterwax. William Dyer, magna cum laude. Nina Campbell. Warren Thrakill, cum laude. Tanya Pulley, summa cum laude. Becky Meyer, summa cum laude. Angela Nugent, magna cum laude. Wayne Butke. Jesse Gordon, magna cum laude. Paul O'Connell, summa cum laude. Scott Bovin, magna cum laude. Robert Ratliff, summa cum laude. Stephen Jurens, magna cum laude. Brad Johnston, summa cum laude. Daniel Wheeler, summa cum laude. Cedra Beckman, cum laude. Mickey Phillips, cum laude. Nicole Adams, cum laude.
Let's have one more round of applause for our bachelor's degree candidates. Will the associate degree candidates please rise? Chairman Howard, these candidates have completed all the requirements for the associate degree. On behalf of the faculty, I recommend that the associate degree be conferred upon these candidates at this time.
With the authority granted to me by the State of Alabama and approval of the Board and Faculty of Columbia Southern University, I hereby confer upon you the associate degree and all the rights and privileges that come with it. Please move your tassel from the right to the left side of your cap as a sign of all this great achievement. I congratulate you and applaud you.
Will each candidate for the associate's degree please come forward as your name is called to receive your diploma?
Presenting the College of Business, Ginger Ricker.
I love you.
Lorraine Jones. Diana Robin Hamilton. Sheila Riles. Sharon Hayden. Noemi Athenas. Dominic Walker. David Curry. Gerald Wade. Stafford E. Dudley Sr. Presenting the College of Safety and Emergency Services, Ronnie Banks. Darren Bledsoe. Cicero Bevel. Benjamin Miller. Nisala Canty. Anita Hemphill. Carmen Petty Scott. Amanda Hollinsworth. April Brooks. Jenny Gibson. Vanessa Taylor. Oral William Banta.
Let's have one more round of applause for the associate degree students. You You know, a name is a pretty important thing, isn't it? I'd like to recognize our master name caller, our registrar, Ms. Rachel Ferris. So, graduates, today we celebrate tomorrow as you return to each of your professional fields. Remember that you are a new and different person. You have earned a credential that has meaning in the professional world. Finally, don't forget to thank your family, friends, and colleagues who have supported and encouraged you. They have been there wanting the best for you while waiting for you to achieve it. Make their wait worthwhile. Return their investment in you as many times over as you can. Please rise and applaud all those who have supported you. Okay, you may be seated. Save some of that applause, you know, you've got to have it for later. Thank you and good luck, graduates of the Columbia Southern University class of 2013. You have earned it. Pastor Buford Lipscomb will now deliver the benediction.
Congratulations to all of you seniors. Could you bow your heads with us as we pray and close? Father, as these new graduates of Columbia Southern University, the new alumni, 2013 graduates, we pray your direction, your blessings. May you guide them with your own hand into their future. We thank you, Lord, for all that this moment means in their lives, how they will look back upon it, Lord, with fond memories. We pray, Lord, that you would bless them as they go from this great hall today back into the places and purposes for their lives. May their places and purposes be yours for each one of them, Lord. We thank you, God, for this day and the days ahead in their lives. In Jesus' name, amen.
Will everyone please stand for the platform recessional? Please remain at your seats. Congratulations, graduates. Please remember to stop by the information tent to pick up your gift. Now, on behalf of Columbia Southern University, I now welcome you to throw your hats, if you want, because this ceremony is now concluded. Thank you. Good luck.